Hey, Sashan, what is going on? Went to the Walmart, got some non-alcoholic Two Roots Brewing Company. I don't even know what, anyway. This stuff is god awful. Tastes like fermented grass. Super bitter. Yeah. They didn't have my O'Doul's. So, this was their other non-alcoholic beverage, and it's crap. Anyway, for a few days now, I've had a couple hours each night to do some programming after work. So, I've been updating some programs, getting some stuff out that I don't use anymore in Python. So, I'm updating my projects so that they'll still run without this thing I wasn't using anymore. And so I've been updating this NPC generator thing for Traveler, Mongoose Traveler. It's customized, got some other stuff in there from Traveler 5, might be in some of the stuff here. So, in a nutshell, I don't have a manual for this thing. It's on the GitHub. I'll put a link below. There's no manual. You'll have to fend for yourself on how to use this thing. But I added this guy in yesterday. Was it yesterday I added this in? So you can do roles. Yeah, I did this yesterday. I added this in yesterday. So it's a character generation that has a die roller in it. Just like my 3D models. I somehow figure out how to add boobs onto my 3D models. Here, in my Traveler apps, I've somehow added die rollers to everything, to all my apps. Because you never know, you might need dice. And later on in the video, I'll show you how else to roll dice with this thing from DOS. Okay, so to make a character, it's pretty simple. I can remember. You got your roll style for your characteristics. Standard is your 2d6 roll straight down for each characteristic. You got heroic, and I looked in my code from a couple years ago to see what heroic does, and it looks insane. I want to say it re-rolls low numbers and keeps fives and sixes or some nonsense. Anyway, it's heroic, so your character will be heroic. Method one, borrowed from Dungeons and Dragons. Basically, you're rolling three dice and keeping the highest two dice. I made this roll before there was a boon roll. Now there's boon rolls in Traveler, so I could have just used the boon mechanic for that instead of rewriting the boon mechanic from scratch to do a method one roll. Anyway, it keeps the two highest rolls from a 3d6. That's your characteristic. Next is five. I looked in this. I had to look for that because I don't even know what Nexus 5 does. Nexus 5 does a 1d plus 6. So you roll one die and then you add 6 to it. That is your Nexus 5 character. Nexus 6. I could have sworn Nexus 6 was that roll, but no. Nexus 6 is, for some weird reason, a 2d6 plus 3. Why on earth a 2d6 plus 3? Probably Nexus 6. I have no idea if that works. In theory, your stats can only be up as high as F, but your Nexus 6, so your stats could be higher than F. Right? No, that. Hang on, hang on. Okay, that makes sense. So when you roll, your stats are 2 through 12, right? Yeah, 2 through 12. I want to say these guys here are 2 to 12, but this one here is it's f 5 to 15, right? Yeah, 5 to 15. is your range when you roll your character using Nexus 6. So that's kind of cool. Mediocre. I had to look this one up. It's 4d3. Sounds kind of crazy. 4d3, that's a mediocre character. So a 4d3 is what? Ranged from 4 to 12? Your chance of rolling a 12 is so unlikely. Your chance of rolling a 4 is very unlikely. I think that's what it is, a 4d3. So this thing does, can I do a 4d3? Let's see. I can do a 4d3, so 9. So, what is it, from 8, no, from 7 to, usually about, 7 to 9. Pretty boring rolls. And what was the other one? 2d6 plus 3. What does that look like? So we got some 12, 12, 15. There's a 15. 13, 15. And what was the other one? D6 plus 6. So from 7 to 12, it looks like. That's not too bad. You can't roll less than a 7. Anyway. I'll just use standard here. Random. You got your random male, female. You can choose male, female, or random. Let's go with female. Why not? Age. This is the age when they muster out. Kind of, sort of. If you get a critical success or a critical fail, however you want to see it, when you roll for your career, whatever you roll for your term, your chance of leaving, if you roll a natural 12, I think you're stuck. You're stuck for another 4 years in your career. You're hoping to leave, but they need you one more time. One more mission. You're like, oh crap. 4 more years. So even if you say 38, it might be 42 before you're out of career jail, and then you can start adventuring. Strength, anything, if it's 0, that means you're looking for any character above this. You want anything above, any skill level above 0, any soul standing. You can crank these up. Maybe you want a chick that's super smart. And maybe they're psionic also. And you put in your psionic strength level. These are minimum numbers here. And they came from a tech level 10 planet, maybe? And you want their career to be... I don't know if this is going to work. I would say Scion for now. You know what? Let's make them a rogue. Why not? I don't know if that's going to work, because I'm telling it to be rogue. See, some of these are, what they call it, will crash the program. If you say, I want to be young, but super, super smart, that's not going to happen. Or you want to be old and old. You want to be old as the emperor, you know, super, super old, but you still want to be super strong, super dexterous, super whatever. May not happen. So the algorithm will just run and run. We'll see. We shall see. Atmosphere, you can, depending on what version of Traveler you're using. Traveler has switched back and forth over the years from basing its hydrographics on atmosphere or on the world size. World atmosphere or the world size? You pick. It doesn't matter. If you know what you're looking for, you can notice little weird things. Because this program, not only does this program make a character, it's making their home world. And then the AI, set at random. You got one, let's see, what do you got here? You got one, two, three, four, five, six. You got six AIs. Random means the AI is going to pick one of these. So if it picks personal development, when it's making the character, it's going to try to roll on charts that will do the personal development, like the plus one strength, plus one dex. Service skills, it tries to roll on the service skills table. Advanced education, it'll do its best to roll on advanced education table. Officer skills, specialist skill tables, or just, if you pick this AI, it will just roll randomly from any chart. Instead of focusing on one of these charts, it'll just, each turn, it grabs from a random table. If it can. Sometimes, if you're not an officer, you don't get to do the officer thing. You know, that kind of thing. So we'll just leave it on random. Muted, it's got three voices. Two of them work, the US voices work, the Google one won't work. Also the keep doesn't work. It says it's keeping a traveler character. If you like a character, you can keep it, stores it into a database, but there's no database with this. So you can click on that, nothing's gonna happen. It does put raw data files in the data folder. It creates a raw list, whatever. You can go through at your leisure and just, if you're curious, see what kind of random NPCs were made in the process of generating your most elite character for NPC roleplay. You could play as a character, I suppose, but this is mostly for NPCs. And then you got your homeworld stuff. Characteristics will show up here, all this stuff here. If you're married and have kids, you'll have family members, that kind of thing. What else? If you put a check mark here, this is a secret. If you put a check mark here, it'll show a picture of the freaking character. If I bothered to make a picture of that character, there's like 30 choices of characters. There's not a whole lot of old people, so if your character ends up old, chances are it'll draw a blank because there's no old people in its library. One day I'll finish that. Let's fire away here. You'll notice it's not really doing anything. It's screaming like crazy. Because it's rolling up thousands of characters. Because I use brute force programming. So it's rolling up thousands of characters until it matches the one you chose. Now we chose a career of rogue. But we want the person to be psionic. So how, that might take a while. Because if I had just said, make a psionic character, they immediately go to the institute. Congratulations, you're psionic. They pay the 5,000 credits or whatever, and they go for testing. Turns out they're psionic. What do you know? But since I gave them the rogue career, they're going to have to do the unique role on the unique, was it life? Life events table, there's this one unique life event. There's a life event table, and then there's the sub table of that, where something weird happens in your life. So you have to not only roll the life table, but you have to roll that special thing on the life table that says, you go to the institute to see if you're psychic. And then I have all these other things here, like they have to be education 12. So you see where this is going. The more changes that you make, the extreme less likely your character being rolled is going to match this. But still, way faster. Even if it takes an hour to come up with the character, that's way faster than you doing it by hand with dice. How long does it take to make a traveler character by hand? If you've memorized the career tables, the mishap tables, and the life event tables, if you've memorized all that for the careers and the aging crisis thing and the mustering out and doing all this stuff down here, doing the equipment, the weapons, the cashing out stuff, rolling on the skill tables. If you know the rules by heart and you can do it, if you're pretty good and you're not distracted, you could roll up a character in about 20 minutes. In 20 minutes, I'll have like 10,000 characters generated. But anyway, so I'm going to have to kill this because can I stop this? Can I scroll? No. Oh, okay. It's got 5,490 characters it's generated so far. That's a lot. I mean, the data file is filling up with 5,700, 20, 30, 56, 57, 58, 5,849. We're on 6,000 almost. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. 6,000. We're at 6,000 characters now. So 6,000 lines of data. Yeah, so I picked a criteria that's kind of just close that. Did it die? And let's run it again. Run it again. Anyway, it's an EXE file. You download this. So I downloaded this just. It's pretty simple. Gives you this little thing here. Can I increase the size of this? Yes, no. Oh, I can. Okay. So it's got a little thing, a little cheat sheet that runs in the background. When I hit new, let's just do this, hit new. So it rolled up nine characters. The AI used was four, which was one, two, three, four officer skills. Were they an officer? Nope, doesn't look like they ever became an officer. They were trying. They were incomplete in a whole bunch of stuff. Anyway, so you got a picture of this girl. Let's do just females, just for the heck of it. It takes a little bit longer to do females. I think there's. Oh, I don't remember what the percentage was. It's not 50-50. I want to say females are like guys are 42% and females are 58%. Anyway, so these are all chicks. And you can go here. These are all dudes. Or you can leave it blank, leave it random. That's way faster because it's not killing off the girls if you're looking for a dude, or killing off the guys if you're looking for a chick. Anyway, there's no save or anything. It's just you look at this, you can copy and paste stuff if you want. But let's make a psionic character. Why not? And they're level 6. What happens? Okay, there we go. Boom. Psy Warrior. Wild talent. Adept. Psy Warrior. And then just make it set it back to a negative one. And then they won't be psionic. Oh, the other thing is if they are psionic, it's got psionic here, 5. Sometimes they're not trained. They're psionic, but they're not trained. So that's a thing. This does Imperial characters. So no Soleimani, where there's no Soleimani DNA being hidden from the players. Not with this generator. This one just does Imperial characters. If you don't like this person's name, you can generate. We can call someone Jimbo. Let's see, is Jimbo a guy's name or a girl's name? Let's find out. Okay, Jimbo is a dude. It's always a dude. Jimba? Jimba is a girl. Whatever you type here, that's their first name. You just gave the computer a first name to use. So when the players say, "Hey, we're here to talk to Jeremy," you're like, "Okay." But you need a Jeremy character? Here's a Jeremy character. A barbarian drifter. And he's psionic. And he was a scout. Now he's a drifter. You wish to speak to him? Here's his skills. One thing I wanted to show real quick is in the data folder. Yeah, raw data. Now it's ugly. Ugliest sin in on my screen. Let's see. But I think see, does this work? Okay. So I can look at it this way. So how many characters did it make? Made 9 characters. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 characters. What? Oh yeah, the first character is the header. So it made 8 people. Here's their home worlds, their starports, the size of the planet. It does the planet first. Then it generates the person. And every one of them is named Jeremy. Because I left this filled in while it was making a Jeremy. And it came up with a bunch of male dudes. Here's their ages, the years they were born, their characteristics. So every one of them was psionic. Oh, yeah, I put a psionic level there. Okay. So here's all the psionic Jeremies that it made. All but one of them was trained. And then you got their skills. Here's their skills. The equipment they have. Alien technology, scientific equipment, ship shares, weapons, implants. How much money, how much debt, their quirks. Well, this last one was has useful contacts. So I'm guessing, yeah, so has useful contacts. That's just the last Jeremy. So these are all clones of the same dude? No, I'm joking. They're all different. So if I leave that blank and do this, what happens? Now I got a random dude. Incid. Go here. And now we got a list of new people. Here's their names. Here's the last person right here. So which of these guys was the best? Let's see. Train, silo. Ooh, A. This person's an A. So A is a plus one in psionic. Anyway. Oh. Let's close this. Let me get back into here. Just wanted to show some crazy nonsense real quick. Now, if I open the program up from DOS, I type in a die roll, 2d6. It'll take a while because it's this .txt with all the trimmings. And it says your 2D roll is 9. Now, this is the poor man's die roller. This, if you don't have any dice in your position, but you have a Windows 10 computer running this program, you just run it in DOS and you give it a die roll. Let's go Flux. You gotta wait, because this is the poor man's die roller. Your flex roll is minus 4. What about, what are those other rolls called? 4DF or something? We wait. I want to say it's a fudge roll or a fate roll. Roll was 0. What if I'm playing Trailer 5 for some crazy reason? And something's hard. This is hard. So a 3D roll. Normally in Trailer 5 you roll a 2D, but when it's hard you roll a 3D. When it's even more hard, you roll 4D. Basically, each D is a D6, and the more you roll, the harder it is to roll under something. So, here's a 4D of 7. You can also do a Bane. What other kind of rolls we got? Bane roll is a 6. You can do... if you're playing D&D, if you're playing D&D using my app, something's wrong with you. D20, gosh. D100. It does most of the dice. It's not doing like D7s and D9 and D11 and D13. I'm not doing all that nonsense. There's apps for those funky dice. These are funky enough dice that I'm doing really like a D09. What's a D09? That's a 10-sided die numbered 0 to 9. Anyway, Oh, and then you can do this stuff. You can do, 3d6 plus 5. Playing GURPS or whatever, Trying to roll under something and you got some difficulty. Roll is an 8. So, what else can you do? You can go into the logs here. Yes. Close this thing. How do we get rid of this? Close that. Okay, so got some logs here. Keeps track of things. So I typed in a 3d6 plus 5. There was the 8. So it's in a log. Then here, more logs, lots of logs. It's just using info. If it was set to do debug, the debugged log would show each individual D6 roll three times for each roll, you know, and adding them up to get a number and then adding 5 to the number to get 8. But this is, it's not using debug mode. Because it's been debugged. So that is it. What else is there? What else is going on? My neck of the woods. I'll probably do a YouTube video tomorrow night. So I'm still doing Python. For 3 days straight, I've been doing Python programming. So I'm in Python programming mode, which means no RPG videos, unless you count this one as a video, and no Skyrim videos. I've been modding my Skyrim since Friday, and I haven't had a chance to play it with the new mods that I've put in and the old mods I've taken out. When I get home, it's 100 degrees, and my AC takes forever to cool things down, and by the time things are cooled down, it's time for me to hit the hay. So it's time for me to hit the hay pretty much right now, so I will talk to you guys later.